Right. So first I'm going to go to our AI avatars page so we can see all of our options, including over 100 new avatars from our HN integration. And you can see a lot of these avatars have different angles available. Some of them, where their clothing and their background are actually quite industry specific. So here you can see a doctor option. We've got someone in a high-vis vest here. So these are really great if you need an avatar to reflect a specific industry for your particular audience. Now for today, I'm going to go with kind of a neutral looking option. Her name's Jocelyn. Keep in mind, we are going to add a filter soon to make this part a little bit easier for you to find exactly what you're looking for. So here's the one I'm going to use. The common use cases for utilizing avatars is to have them serve as a host for your content. So maybe they're teeing up what your viewers are about to see or guiding them through a training series. And you can also have them as an embedded narrator in videos where you're showing a process, demonstrating a product, or you just want a layer of commentary on top of some other footage. So that's exactly what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna have her do a little bit of an intro showing the avatar. Then I'm gonna switch to a screen recording showing a process and just use the voice of the avatar as a voiceover. And then I'm gonna have her come back at the end to sort of wrap up the training. So my recording is just talking about creating color palettes in Vyond. This is what it's gonna be just for reference. And of course I need to know what I actually want my avatar to say and what I want the voiceover to be. You'll hear there's some fun background noise. We're gonna get rid of that in a moment and I'll show you how to do that. So to generate my script, I went back through my screen recording and just wrote out what I wanted to be said. So here's the full script. And then I split it up between what I want my avatar to say and what I want just the voiceover to be. Now, this avatar is going to say, this is her intro and sort of outro dialogue. I'm going to do it all in one avatar video and then just split it in the studio. But you could do it as two separate avatar segments as well. It's totally up to you. So I'm going to copy and paste this over here. Now, another reason I'm using an avatar instead of just a video recording of myself is because I'm going to wind up translating this video into multiple languages. And I am embarrassed to admit I do only speak English. So it's going to save me a lot of time using text-to-speech and I can just more easily translate that and save a lot of time later on. So here's my dialogue. It comes with the Ava voice by default. You could preview and choose other options. A lot of these say tone available, which means there's some other tones for the voice that you can choose from. I'm going to leave it as is and just preview this to make sure it sounds the way that I want.
Hi there, I'm Sarah, your avatar host, and welcome to our training series on adding branding to your videos. In this video, I'll walk you through how to create your own custom color palettes in Vyond. It's that easy. I hope this tutorial was helpful and stay tuned for our next training on how to add custom fonts and watermarks.
Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. I'm gonna go ahead and generate the footage. I do always recommend previewing it to make sure it sounds right. You won't get to see the avatar lip syncing with it yet until you generate, but at least you can make sure that it sounds okay. If you need to change the pronunciation of something, you could change out some phonetic spelling. You could add additional, you know, commas or periods to add pausing and things like that. You just want to make sure before you generate, it sounds the way you want to save yourself some time. As you'll see with the message up here, it's going to take a few minutes for this to process. I've never had mine actually take 10 minutes, but it can depend on the length of the dialogue. This is relatively short, so I think it'll be quicker than that. While it's doing its thing, I'm actually gonna go find a template from our template library to use for my video instead of starting from scratch. So from the homepage, if we go to templates, we've got this page here. There's a number of helpful presenter templates, which I think lend themselves to avatar videos quite well. You can see there's placeholders to really easily swap in an avatar. So I'm going to use this company intro option. I've got it set up here. And now I can just replace this presenter with my avatar. So I'm going to right click, go to replace. Your avatar, once it's done processing, is going to show up in your upload section and as a separate video on your homepage. So I'm just going to resize her to fit the way that I want. And now because she's only going to say a portion of all of her dialogue for this scene, I want to play this back to make sure I cut it off at the right point. So I'm going to click the avatar and go to video playback and just preview to hear where I want to cut her off for this scene.
Hi there, I'm Sarah, your avatar host, and welcome to our training series on adding branding to your videos. In this video, I'll walk you through how to create your own custom color palettes in Vyond.
Okay, pretty happy with that. It's around the 11-second mark, so I'll put that in as my end time. You could use this to trim it up as well if you want to. And now I want to make sure my scene is long enough so that she can actually finish saying all of that. So I'm going to drag this out to be at least 11 seconds as well. And I'm going to move on to our next scene. We'll preview that in a moment. So this scene, I'm just going to clear it out and replace it with my screen recording, which is also in my upload section. And now I'm going to add the voiceover narration. So going back to my script, I'm going to copy all of this and go to audio, text to speech, paste it in, and make sure the right voice is selected so it sounds consistent with my avatar who's using the Ava voice, and hit generate. Now, I'm probably going to need to split this up and space it out a bit so that the timing goes in time with my screen recording. My screen recording, I can see in the video playback, is about 37 seconds, so I might need to adjust my scene length. I'm also going to get rid of that background noise we heard, the clicking and the typing, by adjusting the volume to 0%. Now, I could drag my scene to make it longer. Since it's quite a bit longer this time, I'm going to go to scene settings and make it 37 seconds for now. And then I'm going to just play the scene and split up my audio to put the dialogue in the right places in accordance with what's on the screen.
First, right-click on your first palette color. Click Create New Palette and give it a name. Next.
All right, that's where I wanted to split this one and then space it out a bit before it goes on to the next step. I can see this gap here. I'm pretty sure that's where the next step breaks up as well. And some of this can just be a bit of trial and error on where exactly you want the timing to be for your text-to-speech. I'm also just dragging my background music out here. Okay, so I'll preview this one more time.
First, right-click on your first palette color. Click Create New Palette and give it a name. Next, right-click on each of your remaining colors and add them to your palette. Now you'll be able to easily find and apply your branded colors to your Vyond scenes as assets.
All right, I'm actually happy for the recording to stop there. So I'm going to trim it up to around the 36 second mark. And I'm happy with where the dialogue appears. You'll notice because I split the dialogue, the words you see here are the same as my very first sentence, even though it's different portions of that dialogue. Sometimes that can throw people. If it's too confusing for you, you can also just create each piece of dialogue separately. All right, so now I'm going to move away from my screen recording and go back to my avatar. I'm going to add a scene transition just to make that look a little more smooth. And then I'm going to go back to uploads and add my avatar footage again. There we go. And instead of having her just sit here on the screen, I'm going to mask her into a prop. So maybe put her into a circle or a different shape to look a little more polished. A refresher on masking, just search for the word mask and go to the prop section. And you can find props that allow you to mask other assets in them, like your avatar video. So I'm going to choose this circle, place it over my avatar, and then holding shift, I'm going to select the avatar footage, right click, and mask the two together. Now I'm not totally in love with that placement because I can see a little outlines there. So I'm going to double click and just resize it, super easy, and line up the avatar how I want. And now I'm going to go back to video playback and make sure she's saying the right portion of dialogue for this scene. I'm going to have her start at 11 seconds since that's where we left off last time.
It's that easy. I hope this tutorial was helpful and stay tuned for our next training on how to add custom fonts and watermarks.
Okay, I'm pretty happy with that. I can see it's about 7 seconds, so I'm going to make my scene about that long as well so that it's not too long. Make it a little bit. There we go. Okay. And then I'm just going to add some enter and exit effects to my avatar. Certainly not a requirement. I just think it's going to add some additional visual interest. So you can see she's going to pop into the scene and pop out at the end now. So that ought to do it. There may be some little tweaks along the way that I still need to do, but this should be pretty close to a final product. Let's give it a look.
Hi there. I'm Sarah, your avatar host. And welcome to our training series on adding branding to your videos. In this video, I'll walk you through how to create your own custom color palettes in Vyond. First, right-click on your first palette color. Click Create New Palette and give it a name. Next, right-click on each of your remaining colors and add them to your palette. Now you'll be able to easily find and apply your branded colors to your Vyond scenes as assets. It's that easy. I hope this tutorial was helpful, and stay tuned for our next training on how to add custom font.
All right, so I need to make that last scene a little bit longer, but for the most part, I think that meets my needs. I also really like the mixed media effect. Instead of just having the avatar talking at the whole audience, you know, the whole time, just taking up the whole screen, I think it's a more engaging option. And then again, I can just translate this easily by translating my text to speech and using that with the avatar as well. You can also do the same exact thing with a custom avatar. If you wanted to build a custom avatar, you can have one that's in your likeness with your voice to really personalize it as well. So I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions, you can always reach out to our support team or visit us at vyond.com.